Wait, should I change shirts? Is this cool that I got a lot of, it's really hot upstairs in my room. So is that cool? No,
yeah, just take your shirt off. It's all good.
Yeah, take your shirt off.
I don't want to take off my shirt, dog. Thank you.
East Asia Super League, the emerging basketball league for Asia, now brings you Ballerific, a new show featuring the best professional ballers from around the region, up close and personal.
Good evening, sports fans. Welcome to another episode of Ballerific featuring pro hoop stars from across East Asia. Thank you for joining us as we get up close and personal with some of the region's top ballers. Ballerific is brought to you by East Asia Super League, the premier pro basketball competition this side of the Pacific. My name is Alex, and I'm joined by Banjo Albano. Very pleased to introduce our first guest tonight, part of the U16 and U17 Japan national team. Selected as one of the top players in 2018, 2019, 2019, and 2020 when he was in college, and just renewed as a professional basketball player for the Ryukyu Golden Kings, which finished with one of the best records in the Japanese B-League last year. Everybody, please welcome Daniel Nana. Daniel, thanks for joining us. How you doing?
I'm great.
Awesome. Our second guest is an alum of University of Hawaii, who was the second overall pick in the 2008 PBA draft, taken by the Talking Text, Trofang Texters. The six-time PBA champion, winning five with the Talking Text Home Pals, and the most recent PBA championship with the number San Miguel Gin Kings. Please welcome Jared Dillinger. What's good, JD?
What up, y'all? Happy to be here. Excited to get this show started. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, so JD, you know, you came to the Philippines when there was an influx of Filipino-Americans, or as we call Philams, made their way to the PBA. You were out in Hawaii playing college basketball, then found your way to the motherland in the Philippines. Talk to us about that whole process and what it was like.
Okay, yeah. So let's backtrack this. So when I was hooping at University of Hawaii, end of my junior year, beginning of my senior year, a lot of scouts from the Philippines just started showing up at my practice and telling me that, hey, there's this league out in the Philippines, you know, we really think you would be good over there. I'd never been to the Philippines, not too much knowing what it's all about, really, until I got there, landed, and I'm just bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, looking around like, I can't believe I'm really doing this. Fast forward to the PBA draft, and that was my first real, like, vibe of, man, this is legit. I mean, the place was, it looked like a poor man's version of the NBA draft. No joke. It got the whole Sports Center type vibes, commentators breaking down each draft pick, talking about each player, fans screaming and yelling everywhere for each pick that gets called. And it's just like, wow, this shit's legit, man. I can't, this is real. This is a really big thing out here.
That's awesome. So gonna swing it over to Daniel here a little bit, because we're talking about the process of basketball and getting into it and how you got to the league and became the player that you are. We know growing up you were a multi-sport athlete and were into track and field. Can you talk to us about how you made that transition to basketball and what was the inspiration?
I got injured by track and field, so I cannot continue to play track and field, so I just quit and transferred to basketball.
How old are you when you first started hooping? I was
17.
You said 17?
Yeah, 17.
Wait a second. So you started when you were 17, but you were already on the under 17 national team.
Yeah.
Good decision. Good decision.
Yeah.
Tell us what it meant to you, you know, representing the Philippines in international competition.
Man, I recommend, I mean, if every player can have the opportunity to be on the national team, it's such a different vibe. It's so much fun. The whole country is behind your back. You really, until you're really on the national team, you just don't really know, like, you can't really, you just can't have someone tell you that this is such a big deal. You'll see, like, it's really until you're in, you know, on the squad and you're in your first game and you're sitting there hearing your national anthem, and it's such a cool feeling to have. I can't explain it too well. All my happy moments is really, most of them coming from the national team, because it's bigger than you are, you know, the whole situation and what you're trying to accomplish and trying to achieve. So you really feel everyone's support for every move and every decision you're making while on the national team. It's a great feeling.
Also wanted to ask Daniel, you know, we just said part of the U16 and U17 Japan national team. I'm not sure how U16 was possible when you didn't pick up the ball until 17. But can you talk to us about, like, the international experience on those teams and playing against, you know, teams like Korea and just playing these international competitions and what it was like going up against some of the top teams from different regions?
I think it's good experience for youth generation. International competition, because we can learn different type of basketball style from a different country style, and physically different and powerful basketball different. It's good experience for youth generation, especially.
The JD, you know, as you've heard with East Asia Super League, you know, the format will be launching next season with the top teams from each region competing. What do you think about it, and how do you think it will raise the level of sport in the region?
That's a great idea. I mean, what that league has is going on, it's on the right track, at least from my opinion. It's just really trying to get everyone on board and continuing to have, you know, all the best teams from each country to play in that league for 6 months. That'd be dope.
How do you watch that? Some Japanese players try to go another Asian country and play in Korea. Some players. He's the same generation. So I would like to try same thing. And more Japanese players challenge and Japanese league can progress.
I'm gonna take it back to JD now. So JD, you know, your nickname is the Daredevil. You know, talk to us about, you know, your current routine right now, and how important it is for you to prioritize your body on being, you know, professional and competing at the highest level.
So for the people that don't know, I'm 36 years old now. I'm not as young as young fella Nana over here. I was just talking about you, Nana. I was asking Vange through text message how old you were, because you look so damn fresh and young. How old are you? 23. Ooh. Now that I'm 36, I don't lift that much weights. I really just do calisthenics if I'm doing some type of weight training. Most of my work is just mobility, stretching, activation, and doing my best to stay in shape, aside from getting in shape. As people know, the longer you play in professional sports, you learn that it's easier to stay in shape than to get back in shape. So the key really for me was just to never stop moving. The moment you stop, it's tough trying to get back moving again. That's really been the key for me, for my longevity. it's really just trying to keep a good balanced diet and just staying active as much as I can.
I know both of you are some characters and can do some singing and some dancing. So we'd like to start with some singing challenges. You can sing to any song, rap to, Japanese if you want. Daniel, no problem.
Okay.
You got 30 seconds. You can play the song on your phone in the background and you can sing along to it. Fans and I will vote on who we think is best and then we'll leave it to the fans as well to vote on who they think won the challenge.
Can you hear you?
There we go. Yeah.
It's all right, we good?
We good. Tell us what you got.
Yeah, y'all, I know y'all liking this.
Yeah, it's pretty good, actually. I can tell you've taken lessons.
Yeah.
Wait, all right, I let that go for 40 seconds because it was too good.
How was that, y'all? Was that all right?
I'm giving that 10 out of 10. Daniel, you got to.
There you go.
Daniel, you got to work that out.
The armpits and everything. You got nothing on me, Nana.
JD was moving so fast, his computer was freezing.
Was it? You need to change my shirt too, bro. Too much.
Here we go.
There we go.
That's the normal dancer. Dang, that was way better than me, dog.
All right, well, I'm gonna give style points to JD, but probably actual flow to Nana. So we'll call that probably a tie. And we can settle this with a singing rap challenge.
Ooh.
So now
singing rap? Okay.
Singing or rap,
whatever you're more comfortable with. And Daniel, feel free to do Japanese as well if you wanna intro some fans to some Japanese.
That's right.
All right.
Wait, I gotta get to the part where it starts rapping. Hold on. Y'all know about this?
No, I don't know.
A hit, you don't stop. I can see the bang bang, but you say up jump the boogie to the rhythm of the boogie to beat. Now what you hear is not a test. I'm a rapper to the beat. It's just me, you, and my squads. I'm gonna try to move a feet. See, I am black, and I'd like to say hello to the black, to the white, the red, and the brown, the purple, and yellow. But first, I gotta bang, bang, boogie to the boogie. Say, up jump the boogie to the bam, bam, boogie, let's rock. You don't stop. Your body rock.
Oh my God.
How's that?
That was so good. That was so good.
Oh,
is that all right? All right,
yeah.
Put the pressure on. Pressure on Daniel.
You ain't gonna beat me, young blood. You ain't gonna beat me, young blood.
I'll go Japanese one.
Japanese, do it.
Japanese, all right. You got some.
That's it. That's crazy.
Very different sounds, but I love it. Nice. There we go. That's a wrap, guys. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Alex.
Thank you for singing and dancing skills. Really looking forward to this next episode. And we'll send you guys some clips as they come out and keep you guys updated.
Cool. Yeah. Sounds good, Alex. Thanks for having me, y'all.
Thanks, fellas. You guys be safe. We're looking forward to seeing you guys back on the court. And just keep training and keep doing your thing.
Thanks, buddy. I'll hit you up, man.
Yes,
y'all
sir.
Take care.
Thanks, everyone.
Nice to meet you, Dan.